So now we are going to do the aggregate function. Now what is aggregate function? Just I'll show you all that if I take out, if I use this large, small or average function, let us suppose I take out this average of, or maybe it's better to understand sum. If I take out some of these numbers over here which I have, right? So I get an answer of 950, something very big. So I'm getting answer for D107 till D111. So all these cell ranges, for all these cell ranges, I get the sum. Now, if I maybe, let's suppose this cell, I remove this cell, I hide this cell. What happened again, I'll show you all. The answer is, I'll just write it over here. Or I'll just copy and I'll paste the value instead of pasting the number, I paste the value. So I've pasted the value. As you can see, there is no formula. I've pasted the value over here. Now, if I hide this cell, if I hide this row, let us see what happens. The value is still the same. Can you see? Even if I have hidden the cell over here, or if you hide a cell, a row from here, the value still remains the same because this calculates the sum of the rows from 107 to 111. All those rows, it takes the sum of all those rows together and it takes out the sum. But so it basically considers the hidden cell. It will not give you the sum of these three, which is 4, 7. As you can see, I've selected these three cells. The count is 3 and the sum is 4, 7, 9, something like that. But the answer over here is still this. Why? Because it considers the hidden cell. Now, why do I am saying this is that, for this, if we want to ignore the hidden cells, then we use something called an aggregate function. So, aggregate function is a function which is a group function, you can say. Why? Because it has 18 functions in it and it ignores the maybe the errors, the value. If you have any errors over here, it ignores that. Or if you have any hidden cells, it ignores that. So it's a very interesting function which we are going to see. It returns, so I'll just click on this aggregate. And we have, you can see 18 or 19, sorry. You have 19 functions over here which you can use. Normal functions. So these are the very normal functions which we use. But now, we are using it with the aggregate. So what happens, what is the difference, we'll just see. We are dealing with the large. Okay, so I'll just select the large. I'll select the large from here. And let us take out for the quantity. So I have options. So I just, when I click on comma, I get various options over here. Now let us go one by one and see what happens. Ignores the nested subtotal and aggregate functions. Now what are nested subtotal and aggregate functions? Suppose here somewhere you have used any subtotal or aggregate functions within your range which you are going to select. Then what it does, it simply ignores that. Ignores the hidden row, nested subtotal and aggregate function. So if you have hidden any rows over here, it ignores that and it will calculate accordingly. Ignores the error values, ignores the hidden rows, error values, ignores nothing. So if it ignores nothing, that means it gives a normal large answer to the large sum, large function. So large, if I want the second largest, so my answer should be 2100 over here. The second largest in the quantity is 2100. If I ignore nothing, right, then ignore the hidden rows. If you only want to ignore the hidden rows, if you only want to ignore the error values, if you want to ignore both the hidden values and the error values, so these are the various options. Let us go for ignore hidden and the error values. Then obviously we need to select the array. So this is this array which I have selected over here, and the kth number, which is the second largest, I want. So I'll just click on OK, and which is 2100, absolutely perfect. Now if suppose I delete any of or remove any of the rows over here, let us do one thing, let us make a small change, let us make this as 2400. So now the second largest becomes 2400. But as soon as I remove this, so I'll just hide this row, the answer you can see has changed to 2100. If I had calculated using a normal large function, I would have still got the answer as 2400, but still here, as I have selected, as I have used the aggregate function and I have tried to ignore the hidden rows, I get the answer as 2100 over here. So this is the second largest number which I got. The next and it ignored the hidden rows. See, you can see a hidden row, the row has been ignored, so it is simply ignored by the aggregate function. If you had any errors, then what to do? Then what is the solution? So if maybe I do something over here which gives me an error, 7 divided by 0 maybe, so it will give me an error obviously. So it has given me an error, and what the answer over here is, it's 1500. Why? Because this is the first largest, this is the second largest, and this is the third largest. So now the answer has changed to 1500. If I use a normal large function over here, it gives me an error because you are selecting an error, so output will also be an error. See, it gives you an error. So basically, aggregate function ignores the error values, the hidden rows, the subtotal aggregate totals if you have any calculations, any sort of. So basically, it's very helpful when you want to ignore the hidden rows and the error values. Then using aggregate functions becomes very easier. Similarly, you can do for the small, similarly you can do for the average. Let us take on the same thing for average and see what happens. So aggregate, and I'll select the average from here. So one is the average, is big. Then I need to ignore the hidden as well as the error value. So 5, comma, array can be this particular array over here. Now, okay, so there is no k. So it gives me it gives me an error because I have selected only hidden rows from here, which is 5. Ignore only the hidden rows. So it gave me an error because there is an error over here as well. So I'll select ignore hidden as well as the error value. So basically it's 7. So I'll write a 7 over here. And see, it ignored the error value. Now one more thing to you all notice is that I have selected the range of 107 till 110. So if any row is hidden between this, will only be ignored, right? Because I have hidden one row, which is 111. Can you just see over here? 110, 112. So I have removed the 111th row, which is not inside my range. So it doesn't matter at all, right? But when I hide something maybe inside the range, if I hide this particular row, which is inside my range, my value changed because I have selected from 107 till 110, but the 110th row was hidden, so it ignored the hidden row and the value also changed. So this is how you use the aggregate function, in which you can simply ignore the hidden and the error values. Thank you.